In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus be with you all.
And with your spirit.
The gospel today tells us the parables of the treasure found in the field and the pearl of great price. Who are they? It is our God, who is the treasure and the pearl of our life. We oftentimes fail to realize how special our God is, how much he wants our attention, but more than that, our love. For the times we have failed to realize that he is the pearl of great price, we turn to the Lord and ask for his pardon and peace.
Lord Jesus, living word, you are the source of all that is good. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, giver of life, you lead us to everlasting life. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, just judge, you will come in glory on the last day. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory to the highest, on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. O God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, Almighty God and Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Take away the sin of the world, receive our prayer. Seated at the right hand of the Father, mercy on us. Be to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. You alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. To God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation and nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that, with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings.
The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, "Ask something of me, and I will give it to you." Solomon answered, "O Lord, my God, you have made me your servant, king to succeed my father David. But I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding heart to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours?" The Lord was pleased that Solomon made this request. So God said to him, "Because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for understanding, so that you may know what is right, I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now. And after you, there will come no one to equal you." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, We know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. In your heart, knowing your lips, as you're waiting for him this gospel, in the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again, and out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net thrown into the sea, which collects fish of every kind. When it is full, and they haul it ashore, and sit down and to put what is good into buckets. What is bad, they throw away. Thus it will be at the end of the age. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Do you understand all these things?" They answered, "Yes." And he replied, "Then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I don't watch a lot of quiz shows, but there is one that I really like to watch, and that is Jeopardy. Because the people that are on Jeopardy know so many facts that I don't. When the questions are asked, they immediately know the answer. When I listen to them and I wonder how they're so smart. And yet, they know the details. But I wonder whether they know the story behind everything they answer. In our first reading today, we have Solomon, the young king. He had a lot of knowledge, I'm sure. But God asked him, "Ask me something, whatever you want, and I will give it to you." And Solomon says to the Lord, "All I want is an understanding heart." And what is that? All I want is wisdom. And God was so pleased. He said, "You could have asked for anything. A long life, wealth, the enemy destroyed, anything else. But you asked for wisdom." And Solomon was known and still known throughout of history as the one who had all the wisdom of the world. What is wisdom? It is certainly something beyond knowing the facts. The intellect can know a lot of details, but wisdom is knowing the difference between what is right and what is wrong. Wisdom knows the truth and follows it. The other day, I had the opportunity to go to see Oppenheimer, the movie. And Robert Oppenheimer was a genius. He knew a lot about science. He could put all the mathematical formulas together. And he created the atomic bomb. He spent 3 years in Los Alamos. And what he did, he brought all kinds of people together. And he had the knowledge of creating this weapon of destruction. And when they tested it on Los Alamos, the crowds who worked on it clapped and rejoiced. But then, a couple days later, that bomb was dropped on Hiroshima. And a couple days later, another bomb was dropped on Nagasaki. And thousands upon thousands of people, innocent civilians, were killed. And Oppenheimer, after that, saw beyond the facts. He knew his talent, and yet he made what he said, a wrong decision if destruction was the answer. And so he spent the rest of his life trying to make sure that this would never happen again. He was persecuted for his beliefs, and yet there has not been a bomb like that dropped since 1945. He got wisdom. He looked beyond the facts. And yet, each one of us should be asking for that same kind of wisdom. We may not have the intelligence of Oppenheimer. We might not know all the facts of the people that are on Jeopardy. But each one of us should be asking, like Solomon, to the Lord, "I want, above everything else, an understanding heart. I want wisdom." And wisdom is so much needed for us today. Jesus said, "Seek first the kingdom of God, and everything else will be added unto you." C.S. Lewis once said, If we look for the first things and follow it, then we will find that our life comes together. But if you look for the second things and think that's going to satisfy you, you will not only lose the first things, but you'll make a mess of your life. We know that many people are looking for what will satisfy them. They're looking for happiness. And sometimes they're looking in the wrong direction. They're looking for the second things and what they could be. Sexual pleasure, wealth, drugs, alcohol. And when they look for the second things, go for example, with pornography today. We know how rampant it is. It's a multi-billion dollar industry. It's something so easy to experience. Just push the button of your computer and it's there. But what does it do to you? It changes your whole idea of yourself, of your own masculinity and femininity. And it often destroys people, especially young people today. If we seek God first, then perhaps when the temptation comes, we'll realize the consequences of making the wrong decision, and therefore be wise enough to make the right decision. We know that alcoholics, they think that the next drink will satisfy them completely. And so they continue to drink. They're looking for the second things, not the first. Because oftentimes their families are destroyed. Their marriage is broken. They lose their jobs because they made the wrong decision. AA is a wonderful organization. The first principle of the Alcoholic Anonymous is to know what the problem is. And the second is to turn to the all-powerful, turn to God, who has the opportunity and the love for you, and he wants you to make a wise decision. Wealth, oftentimes we think we're going to make it big. Look at the people in the stories told about those who won big at the casino or had the lottery ticket with the right numbers. They squandered oftentimes and they end up poor. What the Lord is saying to us is that we know what is going to happen to us if we do the wrong thing. But we don't have the wisdom to do it right. And that's why our gospel tonight is telling us that we should seek the treasure, the right thing, and sell everything else to get it. And what is the treasure? It is our God who loves us so much, who has the power and the desire to give us what we want. And he knows that the best is the wise decision, the wise choice, whenever we are in a situation where the opposite might destroy us. The Lord is saying, I am the pearl of great price. In order to get it, I have to get rid of everything else. And we say we have no power to do that in our own life. We're addicted and we can't do anything about it. Well, in our first reading today, God is saying to Solomon, what do you want? And Solomon says, I want an understanding heart. I want to be able to discern what is right and not do the wrong. And Jesus is telling us, like God told him, you have asked for the right thing. I will give it to you. And so tonight, if we're looking to find peace and happiness in our life, let's go for the first things. Let's first seek the kingdom of God, and everything else will be added unto it. The Lord never pushes us. In the last parable of the gospel today, we see that the weeds grow up, and at the end, they're put aside, and only the good, the wheat, remains. So we ask the Lord that we don't have to choose the weeds, but let us always choose what is going to enrich us. And then we have chosen the best way. We have chosen the pearl of great price. And the Lord will never, never go back on his promise. Just ask me for what you want. And if you say, like Solomon, all I want is the wisdom to do it right, he promises he will give it to us. But the choice is ours. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray. God said to Solomon, ask something of me, and I will give it to you. We hope to emulate the wise Solomon as we turn to him now and ask for these petitions.
For the church, that we may joyfully share the treasure of our faith with all those searching for hope and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our nation's leaders may exercise wisdom reminiscent of Solomon's when working to make our country a more perfect union, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace on our streets, peace among nations, and peace in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have hurt us, those who disagree with us, and those who have abandoned us, that we may all be open to reconciliation and forgiveness,
We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are sick, for their families and friends, and for all who bring care to them in their need, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially those for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase of vocations to the priesthood, the permanent diaconate, and religious life in our diocese, especially from our parish family of Mary, Mother of Mercy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the legal protection of the unborn and all life, from conception to natural death, and that all of us might provide generous assistance to mothers and women who struggle with pregnancies and responsibilities of bearing new life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts, and for all our intentions, spoken and unspoken, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of wisdom and mercy, in your generosity, you have blessed us with the promise of the kingdom of heaven. May we treat your kingdom as the treasure it is, and pursue it with the joy and perseverance of those in the gospel. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Lift up
your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim.
In the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For in the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, We offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Dennis, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And
with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace to you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Yeah.
Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Have a beautiful weekend and a wonderful week ahead.
Jesus, Lord, and Redeemer.